Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. In today's video, we will learn how to navigate in RoboDK's environment and how to use some of its basic features. Let's jump right into it. As I mentioned in the intro, I will give you access to all the files I'll be using so that you can follow along the different steps. You will find a folder a bit like this one. We are now covering Module 1 RoboDK Environment and Simulation, so let's open it. And we are in sub-module 1, so RoboDK environment. Here you will find 01A rectangle, so let's drag and drop that here. If the drag and drop doesn't work, you can always simply use here open and find the right path and just open the file this way. This station is very simple. I kept it simple so that it's easier to learn. So we have one robot here, one tool. The robot is a KUKA KR-R900. And that's pretty much all we have. So here, as I already mentioned, this is your 3D environment. If you want to navigate in the 3D environment, you will mainly use your mouse. So to pan from left to right or up down, you will use the middle button of your mouse or the scroll wheel button. So if you click on the scroll wheel button, you'll be able to move left and right, up or down. You can zoom in by using the scroll wheel, so just like that, it will zoom by increment. If you want to have a smoother zooming experience, what you can do is press your scroll wheel and then press once your left click or right click, sorry, while still holding your scroll wheel. This way, if you move up or down your mouse, you'll be able to zoom. So once again, press your scroll wheel, hold it, and press your right click once, and then you can move up or down to have a more fluid zooming experience. Now for the rotation. Rotation will happen if you simply press your right click and hold it. Then if you move around, you'll be able to move it like that. You can go back here to the isometric view, or you can decide to see the station from the top, from the front, or from left or right, like that. Perfect. On your left, you will find your station tree. Station tree, as I already mentioned, is super important. Most of your work will happen here, or in fact, most of the organization of your work will happen here. This is where you will create your program. This is where you will manage your objects, your targets, your robot, everything, in fact. There's one super important thing to understand about RoboDK in general and about your station tree. It's the parent-child relationship. The parent-child relationship is a way to kind of hook up multiple objects together. If you see here, you have an indentation between the different objects we have. So we have our tool, which is a pencil. We have our robot, which is indented to the left once. We have, and then in the left, once again, so you have the reference frame or the robot base, and then you have one folder, which is the whole station. This is what we call the parent-child relationship. So if you have an indentation, that means that's the child of the object that is just on top of it. If you press the little white arrow here, everything that disappears when you are collapsing an object is a child of that object. So here, the robot has one child, it's the tool, the frame here has one child, it's the robot, and then so on and so forth. If you delete one object here, all the childs of that object will also disappear. We can close the window here. By the way, if you want to reopen a station that you already had open, you can go to File, Open Recent, and we can go here, 01A rectangle. We can also press Control 1 to reopen the latest open stations or objects or whatever is the last thing that you opened. Next, here you will see we have the different reference frames. So we have our TCP or tool center point. This is our tool. We have a reference for our robot flange. We have one reference for our robot base here. So those will be important to either position objects or target with respect to those reference frame, or to simply move the robot around. You can hide and show those targets as you need. So in this case here, we have a TCP, so we don't necessarily need to see the frame of the robot flange. So what we can do is simply right-click the robot and click here visible robot flange, and this target or frame here will disappear. So that's awesome. I can do the same with the tool. So I can right click and make the TCP invisible. That would keep the tool visible, but just remove the frame below. I can decide to make the tool invisible for itself. So like that, I just have the flange now. And in fact, I just have the robot. I can bring back the tool and bring back its TCP. You can also change the size of those arrows if you feel like they are a bit too big. In this case, I do believe that they are a bit too big. So what you can do is simply press plus or minus on your keyboard. If you press minus, it will reduce the size of all the targets, frame, and TCPs. And if you press plus, it will obviously make those bigger. Again, if you remember, by convention, the Z-axis is the blue axis, the X-axis is the red axis, and the green axis is the Y-axis. Okay, that's pretty much everything for this video. I hope it helped. In the next one, we will learn how the robot works here. We have a robot panel where we can either move the joints, see the position of the TCP with respect to the base, select configurations and stuff like that. So we will explore that robot panel in the next video. This is a very vital portion of RoboDK or interface you will go back to all the time. So you really need to have a good understanding of it if you want to be efficient with RoboDK. I hope to see you there.